State legislatures across the country are trying to rewrite voting laws after the contentious 2020 election. And as John Yang reports, a Supreme Court case argued today will determine how courts assess those new laws.
Last November, Arizona was a battleground in the presidential race. Its narrow backing of President Biden was the first time the state had gone Democratic in 24 years. Today, it was again a battleground as the Supreme Court heard a challenge to two Arizona election laws. Last year, a federal appeals court struck down both of them as violating the Voting Rights Act by discriminating against minority voters. One provision throws out ballots cast in the wrong precinct.
It's often been referred to as the right church, wrong pew.
Tammy Patrick of the Nonpartisan Democracy Fund was an election official in Arizona's Maricopa County, the largest in the state.
So you'll have multiple precincts in a school gymnasium. If you get in the wrong line, you're not going to be on the rolls. You're going to get a different ballot than potentially the one that you would have received in your home precinct.
Patrick found that in the 2012 election, a higher percentage of Maricopa County voters affected by the law were Hispanic. The other challenge law makes it a crime for anyone other than a family member or caregiver to deliver a voter's mail-in ballot. Critics call the practice of campaign workers or community activists collecting ballots ballot harvesting. It was among the practices President Trump railed against last year.
There's such fraud and abuse, and you know about harvesting, where they harvest the ballots and they go and grab them and they go to people's houses and they say, sign here. Now,
in fact, election experts say there is little evidence that the practice leads to fraud. In Arizona, most voters cast mail-in ballots, but many Native Americans and ranch workers don't have mail delivery services at their homes.
Needing to go into town in order to mail your ballot can be a problem, but if you can give it to your neighbor across the street or, you know, the next Hogan in Monument Valley to take in for you, that's incredibly helpful.
Today's telephone oral arguments turned on what standard the court should apply to determine whether election laws discriminate. The law's supporters say the only question should be whether they limit minority voters' opportunities to cast a ballot. Chief Justice John Roberts pressed Arizona Republican Party attorney Michael Carvin.
Is it maximizing participation or equalizing it? In other words, that only comes up when you have disparate results. And why should there be disparate results if you can avoid them?
Because it would eliminate all the valuable anti-fraud concerns implicated in the ban on ballot harvesting. The question is not what's wrong with it. The question is why a system that imposes no unfairness on the group should nonetheless be changed simply because they find a different method of voting more convenient.
Opponents say the question is whether the laws result in lower minority voter participation. Justice Samuel Alito asked whether that was too broad.
What concerns me is that your position is going to make every voting rule vulnerable to attack. People who are poor and less well educated, on balance, probably will find it more difficult to comply with just about every voting rule than do people who are more affluent and have had the benefit of more education.
The court's decision could affect more than just the Arizona laws. It's the first case since the court struck down a key provision of the Voting Rights Act in 2013.
The Supreme Court is looking to give guidance to the lower courts.
Marcia Coyle is chief Washington correspondent for the National Law Journal.
Section 2 of the Voting Rights Act is sort of the last tool standing. The Supreme Court could make it easier to challenge laws that are potentially discriminatory. It could make it harder, or it could make somewhere in between. It was really hard to tell today.
State legislatures are working on new election laws that could be challenged in court. Tammy Patrick of the Democracy Fund.
At this point in time, we really can look at any state in the nation and find examples either in the courtroom or in the state house where election reforms and policies are being taken into consideration.
An Arizona Republican Party attorney Carvin bluntly answered Justice Amy Coney Barrett's question about what's at stake.
what's the interest of the Arizona RNC here in keeping, say, the out-of-precinct ballot disqualification rules on the books?
Because it puts us at a competitive disadvantage relative to Democrats. Politics is a zero-sum game.
The High Court's decision is expected by summer. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm John Yang.